Hello everybody, in this video I will show you how to install Android Oreo on your PC, whether it is a desktop or a laptop, it doesn't matter. So at first let's go to a browser. I use Chrome browser, and in our browser you have to go to www.android-x86.org, drag it up a little bit and go to Android x86 8.1 release, which is Oreo. Now I will click on it. It will take me to another web page, and here there is a link, and I will click on that link also. It takes me to download page. Okay, in download page you can see various formats. I will download x86 64-bit, and I will download ISO file, not RPM file. Okay, since I did this, I will skip this part. Now the first stage, I download the required file to install Android Oreo on my computer. Let's close the browser and go to our VirtualBox. I will initiate it now. Okay, now let's go to new section. Okay, it will ask a name. I will say Android Oreo. Okay, it's a Linux version, and I have to select other Linux 64-bit, and I will say next. Okay. Even in simplest phones right now, 2 or 3 GB is normal. So I will select for memory 2 GB, and I will say next. Here, go with default options and say create. And now let's say next. Dynamically allocate this good. And 8 GB is generally sufficient, but if you want, you can increase it. I will say 8 GB. And now I have an Android Oreo virtual machine. Before starting it, I have to right-click on Android Oreo and go to Settings. When Settings screen come up, I will go to Storage. And in Storage, there is a disk icon, and I will tap on it. Now here, IDE Secondary Master section, I will click on the disk. Choose Virtual Optical Disk File. Okay. Since I have already downloaded Android x86 64-bit, I will select this one. And I will say, double click, and I will say OK here. Now you have to start your virtual machine. In the first stage, we download the ISO file. In the second stage, we set up our virtual machine. And now we are at the third stage. We have to install our virtual machine. I will say start. OK. Now the virtual machine is starting. OK. Now you have a few options. With your arrow keys, go down to the third option, to the installation option. And now let's start the installation. Okay, installation has started. Okay, select C in your keyboard, and I pressed C, create and modify partitions. And I will tap on OK right now with Enter. Do you want to use GPD? I will say no. And now the help is active on the screen. Since this is a black screen, you can't use your mouse. You have to use your arrow key, and I will go to, with right arrow key, I will go to new. Okay, I want a new primary partition. I will tap on enter again, and it says 8 GB, yes. I will tap on enter, press on enter again. Is it bootable? Yes, let's say yes, and okay. Now I will, after I press enter again, I will go to, with right arrow key, I will go to write. It says, are you sure you want to write? Yes, I am sure. Let's write yes and press enter. Writing the partitions to the disk right now. And I have to go to quit after I wrote the partition. Don't forget that. I have to go to quit. Now, as you can see, I have a partition called SDA1 on screen. And I will say, okay, that's all. And which for files the system do I have to format it? I will say ext4. Are you sure you want to format the partition? With left arrow key, go to yes and press enter. Now it's formatting the partition SDA. Do you want to install bootloader grub? No, I will say skip. Do you want to install system directory? I will say no. And now it's writing the files to your virtual hard disk. Basically, it's installing the system. So okay, it may take some time according, depending on your system, I mean, your processor, your RAM, etc. Okay, it copied the file. I will say run Android, and I will just press enter. That's all. I mean, you don't have to change anything here. Android is starting. It may take some time to start it. Okay, main screen has come up, but before doing anything, let's go to mouse icon on the bottom of the virtual machine and go to select orange option. Mouse integration. The green here should turn into orange, and then this means that the guest operating system will capture your mouse or your cursor. If you want to release it, you have to press on right control button. Okay, now yeah, it says it's capturing, and I will say start. That's okay. Okay. Now it's going on. It's setting up your system, and I am pressing on right control. As you see, my cursor became white. Now let's set up our screen size. Go to scaled mode. It's better. And I will say switch. Okay. For a phone screen, it's much better. Now we can see everything. Okay. Capture again my mouse. And I want to start set up as a new machine. Okay. As you see, it's checking some information. Okay, it asks an email. Let's enter an email. Okay, let's say next. Now we have to enter our password. Okay, I'll say next, and I agree with the terms. I'm selecting the default selection. Next. It's still setting up. Please turn off all of the things since this is all of the options, since this is a virtual machine. This is not a real machine. And let's say I agree. No thanks, I don't want another email. And adding finishing touches. Let's see. Our system is coming up. Okay, I'm selecting launcher tree. And for always. Here we go. Our VirtualBox, our Android Oreo on VirtualBox has just come. Okay, we have just finished installing Android Oreo on our computer. Now, what can we do? Basically, you can do everything you do with a normal Android machine, even though the performance may be different. You can test your developed code here, or you can play games here. I will do the second one. I will go to Play Store. Okay, let's say capture now. And I can write my favorite game's name here. Okay, and now I can just say install it. It may take some time installing it depending on your internet connection speed. Okay, as you see, it's downloading now, and then I can start to play with it, and you can do it with other games also. You can test even your own software here to see performance, to see view issues, etc. Now it's installing on my machine, and I can go to my home screen. Okay, by tapping the circular button, and yeah, here we go. Helix Jump is just here. If you want to see other softwares installed, other apps installed, you can just go here, see all of them. And again, I am coming to my home screen, and I'm starting Helix Jump. It's coming up, and it may take some time to set it up, to give the permissions, etc. But at the end of the day, you can start to play with it right now as you do on your phone. And I will say I got it. Okay, now the rest is up to your talent. Have a great day, guys, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to turn on notifications. Okay, have a great day.